Hey, this is Julian Goldie, and in today's video, we're going to talk about five easy tips to rapidly improve your keyword research. And this video is going to save you a ton of time because keyword research is absolutely essential for your website. And if you don't get it right, then you could end up writing loads of content that never ranks or is just too damn competitive to rank for. So, you know, it's really important to get your keyword research under wraps before you begin writing content. And if you haven't done that already, then this video will help you a lot. By the way, before we jump into the video, please make sure you subscribe and click the notifications bell to receive more videos about SEO and link building as well. Okay, so tip number one is to always check a keyword difficulty, you know, of a keyword before you produce any content around it, because not all keywords are equal and some are going to be more competitive than others, which means that it may be extremely difficult to rank for certain keywords and extremely easy to rank for others. And obviously, when it comes to keyword research, you want to pick your battles and find the keywords that are easiest to rank for. So how can you check the keyword difficulty? Well, you can use a tool like Ahrefs, go on there, and you can find keywords between 0 and 10 that are usually pretty easy to rank for. And especially if you find keywords that have a high level of volume and a low level of difficulty, then you're going to be onto winning keywords that are actually much easier to rank for and will save you time in the long run and get you better results. Next up, you have to look at the search volume of the keywords you're going for, because there's no point trying to rank for a keyword if there's no one searching out there for it. Because if you try and create content around that, no one's ever going to find it because no one's searching for it, okay? So for example, if you write an article about a random topic that you've just picked out of the air, how do you know if anyone's searching for it, okay? So you can use tools like Ahrefs or SEMrush, and these are really useful for finding the keyword volume of a certain keyword and seeing how many people are searching for it per month. And the reason this is useful is that you can then figure out, okay, if I write a piece of content, are enough people going to find it, right? So what I usually do is recommend going for keywords that have at least 100 monthly searches. And you may say, okay, is that enough? Surely that's not very many. But the thing is that there will be other variances of that keyword that will multiply the effect. So maybe only 100 people are searching for a certain keyword, but then there are 10 different variants of that keyword. They're all very similar. And therefore your content is going to be found maybe 1,000 times per month. So this is incredibly useful, and it's definitely something to look at before you write any content. And yeah, just definitely take that into account. So now you've got your keyword difficulty and your monthly search volume of each keyword you plan to go for. But before you produce any content, you should also look at the competitors on the first page of Google for that particular keyword. Okay. So if you look at, I don't know, for example, the keyword make money online, then you'd check, okay, how many competitors on the first page have links to their site? So how many backlinks do they have to their page? What's the sort of word count they've produced? Can you realistically produce better content that's to a higher standard? And can you help more than any other competitor on that page? Because that's the thing, you can produce content, but you need to outrank everyone who's already trying to rank for that particular keyword. And in certain cases, that can be near impossible. And in certain cases, it can be incredibly easy, okay? The other thing as well is you want to look at what's your competitor's word count. So how many words have they produced? And can you produce high quality content at a similar word count or even higher than them? And how can you beat them in that way too? Next up, I'd recommend looking at the search intent of your keywords. So figuring out, okay, you've got this keyword here, but what's the user of Google trying to figure out with this keyword? You know, why are they searching the search term, and what problem are they trying to solve with it? And how can your content solve that problem? Okay. Because the thing is that Google's algorithm is continually updating and evolving to move closer to the user's search intent. And it's so sophisticated that it can figure out, okay, this is what the user is looking for, and this is the content that matches it, right? So if you produce content that doesn't fulfill the search intent, or it doesn't match it and it's not relevant, therefore you're going to get lower on page metrics and you're going to struggle to rank your content. So that's why you have to reverse engineer this process first. Now, following on from the search intent, it's also important to check the business value of a keyword to you before you try and rank for it. Okay, so it's all good and well like ranking for a keyword, but how much is that keyword worth to you? Is it going to bring in some sales? Is it going to bring leads, or is it going to generate profits for your business? Because if not, why are you trying to rank for it? Okay. So it's really important to look at not just the search intent of a keyword, but the business value and what it's worth to you. And for example, you could look at, right, Is the user trying to buy something with this keyword? Are they looking for the best product? Are they trying to fix a problem that they actually pay for? So these are all things to consider when you're looking at the business value of a keyword and how much it's worth to you overall. So that's pretty much it for my five top tips for keyword research. Now, obviously, these are the basics, but they will give you an extremely good foundation to consider when you're coming up with your keyword strategy. And it's so important to come up with a keyword strategy before you try and rank for your content, because it's just going to save you a lot of time and potentially a lot of money in the process. And the smarter your keyword research is, the more successful your website is going to be in the future, because obviously it takes a long time to rank your content. It could be months, it could be several months. So you want to get the keyword strategy right in first, so that later on down the line, you don't waste any more time. Okay, so thanks for watching. Please make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. And let me know in the comment section below, what's the number one thing you struggle with when it comes to keyword research? And I'll be happy to try and help you with that.